Hi everybody, it's us, the Wandering Hobbits, here to guide you through days 2 and 3 of the Affric Kintail Way. The journey so far has been nothing short of magical, but the real adventure is just beginning. With Charlie and Dolly, our faithful companions, by our side, we'll venture deeper into the highlands, expect towering peaks, hidden glens, and maybe even a surprise or two along the way. So grab your walking sticks, take a deep breath, and let's continue this epic journey together.
Well, after a beautiful day yesterday, it's now absolutely lashing it down. We've had thunder, we've had lightning. The way you love me is frightening. It's been knocking on the tents. Not the start to the morning we wanted. Hopefully, forecast is for it to lift. So hopefully things will get a little bit better. Tent stood up to it well. It was quite funny watching them light up with the lightning, I've got to say. Great little night's sleep, much needed. In a lot of pain with my legs. But other than that and damp weather, we're in high spirits. We're just going to stay bedded down in tents another 20 minutes and see if it clears. And there's your thunder if you heard it. But yes, it's definitely not the beautiful day it was yesterday. And we're off. Been eaten alive by midges. What started out as a great morning and a great walk is turning into a walk from hell. Midge fest. Only kidding, once we get moving properly, they'll stop. Massive contrast on yesterday. Excuse me, as you can see. Both had an half decent night's sleep, but unfortunately Mrs. P's bag went down. Blow up mattress. So looks like we'll be investing in another there for her, because we can't be doing with that. I believe this is Strawberry Cottage. This is where we've come from, and you'll just have to believe me when I say I left no trace, because I couldn't wait to get away from midges. Right, we'll see you further on. So we've got a little bit further on. It's got to have been the most stop-start morning we've ever had. Me and my poncho, wife with all the straps on the rucksack, we've just struggled. Now we've all got wrapped up and waterproof, stopped bloody raining and we're sweating like mad. Sod's law. But it is beautiful. Just want this weather to lift. And then hopefully we'll have some amazing footage to show. Little doggies are enjoying life. Didn't they? Well, they've both disappeared now. Charlie!
Come on, Cal.
They both had a really good sleep. They took it in turns in getting its sleeping bag last night. So they slept well. Poor Mrs. B didn't sleep well because her mattress went down her bed. So like I said, she needs a new one. Right, onward and upward.
Day 2 of the way was a bit of a challenging start. After pushing through 18 miles the day before, the consequences are definitely making themselves known. Aching legs, tiredness, and the feeling that maybe, just maybe, we've bitten off more than we can chew. As Mr. Hobbit wisely pointed out, the morning rain and thunder didn't exactly encourage an early start. Our packs feel heavier and more uncomfortable after yesterday's long trek, and to top it off, the midges are out in full force, reminding us that the Highlands are as unforgiving as they are beautiful. But despite all that, we're still here, determined to press on and see what day 2 has in store for us. It's going to be a tough one, but with a bit of grit and some hobbit-sized perseverance, we'll find our rhythm and keep the adventure going. Let's get our boots on and hike.
Right, so we've got a bit further down the valley. It's not that the midges are bad at all. Here's me. Oh my goodness, what are you wearing? They're horrible today. I have never been as disheartened by midges as we are today. The midges on steroids. They've had too much Edinburgh. Anyway, it's people in distance doing some sort of work, although I can't see. Because bizarrely, I too have got a black face with the net on like this. Yay! Which is very good, but you do struggle to see. Right, onwards and upwards.
Making our way from Strawberry Cottage through some of the most stunning rolling glens you can imagine. Despite the midges doing their best to join us on this walk, there's a peacefulness out there that makes everything worth it. The serenity and tranquility of nature are almost surreal. Endless green, gentle hills and the fresh highland air all around us. In the distance, the mountains rise majestically, their peaks partially veiled in mist, adding to the magical atmosphere. How stunning.
Plenty of water coming down from mountain tops or hill tops. Wasn't expecting it to be quite this wet in August, but to be fair, now the sun's starting to break through, it's looking absolutely bloody gorgeous over there. We won't tell Mrs. B, but it's actually stunning. She's seems to be struggling here to get over a river in the path. Bless her. Right, onwards and upwards. Sun trying to break through now on the hills. Gives you a bit of a uplifting feeling, because at the moment we need it a little bit. We've decided this trail is called the Frickin' Midge Kintail Way at the moment. Little shits they are. But yeah, that's great in front, and I'm sure there's more to come.
In the distance, it feels like the mountains are continuing to rise majestically with their peaks still partially veiled in mist. But the rain from earlier has left the paths boggy and challenging underfoot, making every step a little bit more harder. Yet it's all part of the adventure. Charlie and Dolly are in their element, bounding through the grass and loving every second of it. Their energy is contagious, reminding us to take in the beauty around us and enjoy this moment no matter how tired we might be. This is what the Affric Kintail Way is all about, pushing through the challenges to experience the pure joy of being out in the wild. As we approach the West Affric section of the Affric Kintail Way, the trail takes on a whole new character. This part of the journey is truly special. Remote, wild and absolutely breathtaking. The lands open up into vast moorlands surrounded by dramatic peaks, creating a feeling of isolation that's both humbling and awe-inspiring. And just look at that wonderful waterfall. It's flowing with such strength due to the recent rain cascading down the hillside with a power that's almost mesmerizing. The sight of it is a reminder of nature's raw beauty. We're also walking alongside the rolling river, its clear waters rushing energetically over rocks and through the glens. The river adds an extra layer of charm to this wild landscape, with its soothing sounding blending perfectly with the surrounding scenery. As always, Charlie and Dolly are loving every moment, dashing ahead with their usual boundless energy. Their excitement is infectious, keeping our spirits high as we navigate this rough terrain. The West Affric area is known for its unspoilt beauty, and it's easy to see why. The only sounds around us are the wind through the grass and the occasional bird calling, and the distant rush of hidden streams. This is what makes the day rewarding.
That's where we've come from. What a lovely, lovely walk. Midges have now finally decided to frick off on the Affric Kintail Way. And this is just unbelievable. And that's just unbelievable with the head net on.
Hey, what were you thinking?
We'll send out. So, just making his way to the youth hostel now. Right, can just see the youth hostel up ahead. That's probably the longest 3 miles we've ever walked for time. must have stopped 30 times to take in the views and video and photos. It's just stunning out here. Not a walk to be rushed. You could do it easily in 3 days if you were young and fit, but you'd miss out on so much taking it in. It's just beautiful, peaceful, lovely. Yeah, looking forward to getting to youth hostel now, and we're gonna have a rest and then we'll crack on a bit more.
As we sat outside the youth hostel, the incredible friendly staff invited us in from the blustery wind and offered us a much needed rest. They treated us to a warm cup of coffee, and even Charlie and Dolly got a chance to enjoy a drink and a rest. The hostel has a well-stocked shop, and luckily for us it had just been stocked that day. This enabled us to buy some snacks to top up our bags. The hospitality was exceptional. The staff's warmth and kindness made a big difference on a chilly day. Their genuine friendliness added an extra touch of comfort to our adventure. It's moments like these that make the way so special. Wonderful encounters with people who truly enhance the hiking experience.
So we're heading down this way towards Camdanbothy, I think it's called. As you can see, the track's very wet and boggy. We're spending more time trying to work our way around these than going forward, which is making it slow. But again, great views, lovely breeze keeping bridges at bay. And hopefully you can hear me wind blowing into the mic. If not, cue the music. So, Bothy ahead. 2 minds what to do now. Don't know to go to the Bothy if it's empty, tempted. But with 2 dogs that will bark at people, then if somebody else turns up, it'll get noisy. Do we push on down past the waterfall to the next building? I think it's like a private building, what's hired out, and wild camp. Our third option is, do we push on to Moo-ving and hope that the campsite there's got a camping space with showers? So, not sure. Anyway, we shall see where we end up.
As we made our way to Camdanbothy, it was a cosy spot that offered shelter and a place to rest, but since there was already somebody there, we decided to keep moving. Charlie and Dolly aren't the best with people around, especially in the evenings, so we felt it was better to press on rather than risk any unnecessary stress. Plus, the fresh air and the beauty of the trail were too inviting for us to pass up. We're pushing forward to find a more suitable spot where we can all settle in comfort for the night. It's all part of the adventure, and we're looking forward to what lies ahead on this incredible journey. Nearly there, lovely. Just round corner. Again. This other one.
He's been promising me that last mile, just at top of this ridge,
we're done. Hopefully it's this one, or I think I may be dying.
You might.
Okie dokie, let's find out. Stepping stones. Stepping stones, 1 and 2 and 3. when you cross the stepping stones. Yay, we're tired. We're very, very tired.
Just over 2 miles past Cambambothy, we've come across one of the most spectacular sights on the Affric Kintail Way, a massive waterfall that takes your breath away. Sheer power and volume of water cascading down the rock is absolutely mesmerising. After the tough hike and decision to push on from the Bothy, this waterfall feels like a true reward. This waterfall is a reminder of why we were out here, pushing through the challenges. It's the perfect boost to keep us moving forward on this incredible journey.
Okay, still making us way down from the waterfall. What a pull down this is. I know the saying's normally a pull up, but it's steep, it's long, it's slippy, and it's hard underfoot. I've got to say, this walk's caught us out a little bit, harder than we'd envisaged. I think quite a lot of YouTube videos make it out to be perhaps easier than it is, or they're just very young and very fit. We're making our way down this valley now, and we're trying to get down to somewhere near the Bothy or the building down in the bottom. And even though we're only 4 miles off more of it, we're going to find somewhere to well camp. We're shot, and even the dogs are shot. Little man down here is trying to make a bed already. Look, he's worn out. Bless him. So yeah, it's been a long, hard day. Fantastic scenery. Been a great walk. Just don't underestimate it.
What a day it has been on the Affric Kintail Way. We covered 10 miles today, and it's been filled with some unforgettable moments, from the relentless bog, the breathtaking waterfall past Cambambothy, to challenges and rewards of hiking through this rugged landscape. As the day came to an end, we found a perfect spot to pitch our tent near a private lodge and by the river. We even set up a time lapse of our camp, capturing the quiet beauty of the evening settling in around us. Mr. Hobbit got busy with his camera and managed to snap some incredible photos, including a rare and magical glimpse of the northern lights dancing in the sky. Now, with tired feet and tired doggies, we're all settled in the tent, ready to rest up for whatever adventures tomorrow will bring. It's these moments, tough, awe-inspiring and peaceful, that make this journey so special. As we drift off to sleep, with the satisfaction of knowing that there's only 4 miles to complete the trail, today's challenges have led to some truly unforgettable memories. We can't wait to see what the Highlands have in store for us tomorrow.
Okay, so we've left this little camping spot in rather a rush because the cows were getting closer and closer, and with 2 dogs, didn't want any aggro. We did leave no trace, I can assure you. Bit windy this morning, bit chilly and overcast, but I've got high hopes for some sunshine coming out, we'll have to look. So onwards to Moo-ving. We've made an executive decision that we underestimated this walk. So we're not walking back, absolutely no chance. Dolly's got paws a little bit sore, but it's not that, we're shot. Poor Mrs. B's absolutely shot, I've got blisters, I'm shot, so Moo-ving, and then we're going to try and get a lift or a taxi for one of us to Cannich to get his car and come back and pick the other one up at Moo-ving. So let's crack on. Although I think most people won't want to stop this close to Moo-ving, unlike us hobbits, here's the perfect little wild camping spot with a bit of shelter if anybody feels they just can't quite make it. What an excellent little spot. I'll back out so you can see whereabouts we are, just before the hunting Bothy.
It's the final day of our journey on the Affric Kintail Way, and we're feeling refreshed and ready to tackle the last 4 miles to Moo-ving. After a good night's sleep, our feet are feeling a little bit better and the doggies are back to their energetic selves, eager to get moving again. Last night we found a nice quiet field to wild camp in, though we had an unexpected surprise when we realised we were sharing the space with a few curious cows. Thankfully they were just as interested in us as we were in them, and we all managed to get some rest with no issues. The trail ahead is gentle with beautiful views opening up as we make our way towards the finish line. There is a sense of accomplishment in the air as we take these final steps, knowing we've pushed through the tough days and come out on the other side. Let's enjoy these last few miles, savouring every moment of this journey.
Well, I'm not sure if this is the Five Sisters of Kintail.
Or the Mull of Kintail.
Or the Mull of Kintail.
Not.
We're not really all that sure. But so far it's been a great walk. So we're about 3 kilometres away from Moo-ving. Looking forward to, I don't know, getting something to eat, etc. Rather than living on dehydrated foods, and I'm sure dogs will be quite appreciative of that as well. It's great to do this walk, it's at its moments, and I've just got signal. And I'm getting loads of text messages through, so yeah, you just get signal roundabout here, which is quite good. So yeah, it's so far so good, it's been brilliant. Get back to you soon. So here we are, the end is nigh. It's been a long haul, difficult at times, but well worth it. The views have been absolutely phenomenal. And it's been great to take the dogs on one. Hard work, but great. But they've also had a field day. So looking forward to his next one. Don't know when or where that will be. I can feel a song there.
We'll meet again. Don't know where. I'm off.
And off he goes. Come on, and folks, that is where we've come from. When you look back and look where you've walked, you've got to say, I'm impressed. We went to the caravan site, or the camping and caravan site. The reception were closed and there were plenty of signs that were saying, if you're here before 1 o'clock, turn around and come back after one. And those were the words. So no ice cream, which we were gonna have. So we're gonna go up to the Jacobite, and there is also a grocery store as well, about a mile away from the campsite. And then we're gonna see if we can grab some form of transport to get us back to Cannich. So we're feeling very chuffed about what we've just walked. We no doubt will review it in a couple of days when we're not feeling quite as achy as you do. And I'll catch up with you soon.
And there's just one thing left to say. I'm a gnu. Wish you a miss you. Yay!
So, we've reached the end of the Affric Kintail Way, and what an incredible journey it's been. Finishing up in Moo-ving feels amazing. There's a sense of accomplishment. After all, the miles we've covered, the challenges we've faced, and the stunning landscapes we've been lucky enough to explore. After finishing the trail, we were greeted with a very kind Citylink driver who went out of his way to help us. He let us on the bus with the doggies from Moo-ving to Drum, and the journey cost us £22.90 each. It was a comfortable ride and we appreciated the chance to sit back and relax as we reflected on our adventure. We spent some time in Drum and then we caught another bus to Cannich, which was a much shorter ride and cost just about £4 each. We decided to camp the night at Cannich, giving ourselves one last evening under the stars to soak up the tranquility of the Highland. As we settle in, For our final night, there's a mixture of pride and contentment. Completing the Affric Kintail Way has been an unforgettable experience, one filled with breathtaking views, unexpected challenges, and the joy of being out in the wild with Dolly and Charlie. This adventure has given us memories to last a lifetime, and while the trail may have ended, the spirit of the journey will stay with us forever.